Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be talking about basically a dream I had last night, and it basically had to do with, well, what I think it has to do with is death and the devil hating me, or a demon hating me. I guess I don't know which, what it was, but my boyfriend thinks it was the devil. So basically, I had this dream, and this dream, it was super duper weird. It wasn't actually me. My soul or whatever, my spirit was in a little boy's body. And in the dream, I had many brothers. Like, I don't remember. It was like four or five brothers. And I had a mom. In the dream, I did not have a dad. And it was like in the old time. So I lived in like this village. And in this village, we lived in these homes or whatever. And in those homes, there was no doors. And it was like we had different type of clothing. We did things a certain way. Like, it literally reminds me from the old times. And so, basically, this village or whatever was all, I don't know if this is the right word, but kind of, like, corrupt, I guess. Like, the village was just not good at all. Basically, if you do one thing bad, you're, like, dead. Like, they can kill you like that. And women had no say in anything. And it was just like what the men say is what goes. And it was just that type of scenario, type of thing. And so since it was so bad, that village, me and my brothers, mind you, remember, I'm in a little boy's body in the dream. Me and my brothers decide to escape. We were planning it. So we decided to escape in the middle of the night. And once we woke up, we literally packed things real quick, packed like a shirt, pants, like things super, super quickly. And like within like a couple minutes, and I decided that I'm going to lit the house on fire. Mind you, I knew my mom was there, but I knew that she would get out because her room was literally the first room entering the house. Mind you, there's no doors. Remember that. And my room was all the way in the back. So I decided to put my bed. I decided to make it go on fire. And right when I did that, me and my brothers just kind of like bolted for it out of the entrance, because there's no door. And once I start running, and I get over the hill that was in front of the house, I looked to the side. Mind you, it was probably like fall or winter because there was no leaves on the trees. And I look towards the forest or whatnot, and I see this creature, this huge, huge creature, just kind of almost like if it was sitting down. And it was completely black, 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 black. And it had these huge horns going up, and the only color it had was its eyes, and its eyes were huge and red, and it was just looking at me. And then I felt the hatred coming from this creature. It wasn't looking at any of my brothers in the dreams. It was just looking right at me. It was looking right at me and looking at me run. And then I look back towards my house, and I see the figure of my mom in the entrance. Remember when I told you I knew in the beginning she was not going to be hurt by the fire that I caused. And she was just standing there, but I know it was her. Like, it was her figure, but it wasn't her. Like, you couldn't see features. She was all black and almost like if she was possessed or something. And I remember saying in the dream, I'm so sorry, Mom. I'm so sorry. I love you, I love you, I'm so sorry, I love you. I just kept saying that, but kind of like running at the same time, but like saying it while looking back, you know. I turn back around and I look, and this guy has this huge knife in his hand. He looks at us running, and then he looks at my mom, and he, it's like I've seen it happening in my head at the same time it was happening. And he basically, you know, with the knife, and he ends up trying to run after us. And I look at the forest again where that creature was. Creature was still watching me only, and this creature, I don't know if I should call it creature or the devil, but was looking at me, and he all of a sudden just like, his huge hands, he sticks his middle finger at me. And again, I just feel like so much hate and like hatred towards me, and like this thing just hates me and wants to kill me or wants to get to me, I don't know. And then when I see the guy that is running after us, and he catches up to me, and we kind of end up in the corner of this other house, and this guy has the knife in his hand, and he's just like going at it, like he's trying to really get to me, and like no hesitation, bruh, like, you know. And then I'm just like, please no, please no, please no. All of a sudden he kind of just stops and stares at me, and then I wake up. And then I remember thinking like, oh my god, that's so weird, this dream was so weird. And I tell my boyfriend the dream that I just had, and he said he thought it was that creature thing was the devil, because I looked up a picture of it, which I kind of regret, but I'm going to post it now. And that's the most similar picture I can find of what it actually looked like. And it wasn't like standing up, and the wings weren't up. It was like, you know, like down. And it was just all black with the red eyes just looking at me, guys. And I'm like, you know, that's what he thought it was. And it was all weird because it was like these deaths, the death of the mother of this guy trying to kill us, and that, you know, demon devil thing. And what is even weirder is that I had that dream last night. And what's even weirder than that is that yesterday when I took out my dog around 1:30 around there, there's this black crow making weird noises, which had never happened before, right? The closest tree next to my house, it was on that tree, and it was just making weird noises. And I was like, oh, that's weird, like that's kind of cool or whatever, you know. I never heard a crow making noises like that, but I think I heard before, if I'm not mistaken, that they can mimic noises. If I'm not mistaken, please correct me, but it was making weird noises, and I was like, oh, just looking up, below, that's cool, whatever. And then my dog is trying to eat something from the floor. And I'm like pulling him, like, no, also, stop. And I keep calling his name, also. And then finally he leaves it alone. And then the crow starts making, like, starts saying the same thing, kind of like, also, you know, also. And I'm like, what the heck? You know, like, I guess it's true, they can mimic, I don't know. And I'm like, okay, so whatever, it's weird, I enter the house. And then I tell my boyfriend what had happened and how I just thought it was weird or cool. And he was like, oh, you know, that means like death or whatever. Mind you, at the moment, I didn't even think about death. I didn't think about that black crows mean death. I just thought it was cool that this girl was making noises or whatever. And it's just all weird that I see that yesterday, then I have this dream about the devil hating me and death. And I just found out that the knocking that I heard the other time in my other story time, that can mean death as well. And that kind of scares the out of me. Like, my brother was saying, oh, like, I don't want you to die. And I'm like, I don't want to die either. Like, this is some creepy stuff. And it's not like I try to mess with it. But I guess at the same time, I shouldn't be making videos about it. But it's just weird that that had happened. Like, there was this one time as well that this, I know it was a demon talking to me, mimicking my mom's voice. And I'm gonna make a video about that. And that was probably one of the scariest things that had happened to me, honestly. But yeah, I don't know. Pray for me, because I don't want to die yet. You know, but if it's my time, it's my time. But yeah, thank you guys for watching my videos. I'll be making more. Love you guys. Have a nice day. Bye.